Well, we had decided to do this one real fast.
We did. This
so
is
what is this one all about?
Well, I want to say, first of all, our last show got blocked.
And you know how you can.
There's no reason for it.
There's no reason for it. We're promoting people's records. We're not making money off them, so I don't know why we got blocked.
But
hopefully we won't get blocked today. We're going to do what I call answer songs.
It's part one and part B. Part one is answer songs.
Yeah, the first song will be the right song, the original song. The next song is the answer song.
Okay, that wasn't where I was going.
Oh.
So, part A and part B. Part A is answer songs, and part B is going to be the flip side. So, we're going to do two different episodes, part A and part B.
Oh, okay, I got it. But we're not going to do part B today. Anyway, we're confusing everybody. You're confusing me. Right now, we're going to talk about answer songs.
Okay, got it.
The first song was the original, and then there was there went through an era where somebody would cut a record to answer the song. One of the songs I remember was He'll Have to Go by Jim Reeves. And then some lady came out with a song that I don't remember, and she said, he doesn't have to go. That's the answer to his song. And there was a lot of those songs.
Okay.
We're starting with Joe Valeno, who sang The Garden of Eden.
Okay.
Kind of a pretty ballad. And I think he just had this one hit. I don't know anything about Joe Valeno.
There's not a lot out there. I did look.
Right. But it was a hit. It was like a pop, like almost adult pop song. I don't know how many teenagers bought this record.
Yeah.
But I always liked it. Well, walking in that garden, the Garden of Eden. The answer song was There's a Snake in the Garden by Jerry Howard. This is the answer song.
Yes.
In
my baby,
I wouldn't want to see a snake in the garden. Yeah.
A garden of love. Every morning. When I would wake up, I knew it was me she'd been dreaming of.
But now
there's a snake
in the somebody's pouring it in on any of this girlfriend. Jerry Howard.
Yeah.
I love this song. Every day is pretty good till all of a sudden there's a snake in this Garden of Eden. So the next song is by Barry Mann. He's one of the great writers of the world in music. Popped out a lot of songs. He and Cynthia Weil, I think it was, that wrote a lot of songs, just like Carol King was in the Burl Building. And Neil Sedaka, they were all cranking up songs.
A lot of people came out of the
So because he wrote a lot of these songs, he created his own song, he put out his own song, his name, Barry Mann. And it was, who put the bop in the bop shabop? The song that made my baby fall in love with me. Who put the bomb in the bomb? Who put the bomb in the bomb?
I don't know the words, I know the song.
Who put the
dip
in the
dip?
Whatever, the bomb. Dip shit? Dip shit. Who was that man? I like his shaking hand. What?
Baby,
fall in love with me. Great, Karen. Yeah. So he's talking about who wrote the songs, like all these doo-wop songs, bop, bop, bop. Yeah, so he's saying he wrote all these great songs, and he was romantic, and my baby fall in love with me. Well, he wrote a lot of the songs that way. But there's another person, somebody we all know, Frankie Lyman, who was famous, Frankie Lyman the Teenager, Why Do Fools Fall in Love, which is his song. This is his song, his answer song, saying, I put the bomb in.
Listen to that high voice.
That's Frankie Lyman. He was a teenager at the time.
Yeah.
Why do cool. You hear that song, right. Not a cool song, love song. I put the rabbit in the rabbit and the dick dog. I did this. He did, you know, a lot of his songs. Let's see, why do fools fall in love?
Well, there you go.
So you get the gist of these answer songs.
I do. They're pretty cool.
They're very creative. So he put, I don't know if this is a hit or not. I don't remember it on the radio. I just think it's cool.
In a way, you know a lot about this stuff. That's good.
Well, I just... You know, most of these are from the 50s, early 60s, so...
That's why I don't know a lot about them.
So, we all... The next song, we all know David Seville. David Seville was the inventor of the chipmunks, and all everybody knows about Alvin and the Chipmunks. Alvin! He'd yell at Alvin down. Well, his first big hit, there was no album, but he knew how to speed up the sound of records, so... He created this first novelty song that I always loved.
So to our granddaughters.
Oh, I used to play it all the time. Witch Doctor, right?
I told the witch doctor I was in love with you.
Yeah, I remember Brittany being up here and Taylan being up here with you and
dancing to the witch doctor, right?
Put the witch doctor on.
So you can see the birth of Alvin and the Chipmunks because he knew how to. That's supposed to be the witch doctor telling what to do, you know. Take this potion and it'll make your girl fall in love with you.
Right.
See? That was the whole
potion
premise.
Potion number 9.
Yeah, another great song.
Right.
Yeah.
Potion number 9.
Yeah. Love Potion number 9, done by the Clovers, and then a British group did a different version. So, anyway.
And the answer song?
So, the answer song is Witch Doctor. And this is a group called The Vogues. Not these. There's a group later on in the 60s that called itself The Vogues. But this is Witch Doctor.
When I went to see my girl,
I don't know this one at all.
He got the trying to find the right witch doctor to make his baby fall in love with.
I don't know.
Which witch doctor? This is all fun stuff, you know? That's what I loved about the 50s. There's a lot of fun things like this. You know?
What's the next one?
Well, the next one's the big hit.
I know this next one.
By the Silhouettes, we all know this song about Get a Job.
Get a job.
Poor guy, wife giving him trouble, his mother-in-law is telling him to go get a job.
Yep. You're not going to school, you're not in the service, get a job.
Get a job. This is a very popular song, as you remember, in the 60s.
And it could apply to a lot of people nowadays.
Oh, absolutely. Get a job, Gen Z.
And then we have a grandson who just wants to work, and...
He'll work two jobs.
He'll work two or three jobs, right. Whatever he has to do.
So we all know, here's the answer song by The Miracles, another popular group. It's called Got a Job.
I Got a Job. I don't know this one, I don't think.
I think this is probably Smokey before it was Smokey the Miracles. Smokey Robinson. This wasn't a big popular song, but he's telling everybody, I got a job.
I got a job.
I mean, Kieran and I have probably both of us have had a job since we were, 15 years old.
Yep.
Up until the date that we retired, but I don't want another job at all. I'm good with the
job
I have.
Come on, Karen.
No, I like working in my garden.
You want to go out and get a job now?
Yes.
Come on.
Cooking in the kitchen.
You're still a young lady.
Yeah, to your standards. Okay.
All right, the next song, and our last song, we're trying to get these show episodes down a little bit in time, because I can talk about these songs all day long, you know that. So the next song is Mr. Bassman, Johnny Cymbal, and I don't know if you remember that song, but it's kind of cool, because in a doo-wop group, they got the lead singer, they got the bassman, Okay. They got the tenor, and this is all about him.
Oh, I know
that's
this
the bass
one.
Man, Paul.
Yeah.
Mr. Bass Man.
Yeah.
Man, how do you do that, Mr. Bass Man? It's pretty cute.
It is.
See, he goes blah, 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 and make it low like blah 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 blah.
Yeah. And what is his?
He says you're the king of rock and roll. Think of that guy going.
Yeah. All right. What's his the answer?
The answer song is by the Marcells.
Okay.
And it's I Want to Be the Leader. See that? Here we go again. This is the answer song. Everybody's talking about Mr. Bass Man.
I never knew this.
Yeah, I want to be the leader. Mr. Bass Man.
Oh my gosh.
Yeah.
I never knew this. I never knew any of this stuff.
Yeah.
This is great. Ron, very, very good.
Well, it's fun. And there was a lot of these kind of songs.
I never knew.
The regular song, and then somebody come up with an answer.
I
want to
be the leader.
I just thought that was all creative. You know, you saw a lot of that in the '50s about somebody would sing about a girl, and then there'd be a song that list a bunch of girls, like Short Pant Panty was doing this, and Long Tall Sally was doing that. So you had a lot of counter-fertilization going on between songs. And,
well, this list was very good. Very, very good. Yeah. Stuff I never even knew. Yeah.
Anyway, these are the originals and then the answer songs for today.
Very creative.
And I hope that it's kind of a new stuff for a lot of people out there. I hope you got a kick out of it. So we'll end the episode. We're trying to make them a little faster for people.
I love you.
I love you too.
All right, sweetheart.
You're my answer.
It better be. Thank you for joining us today. See you on the flip side.
Yeah, that's the next group we're going to do. Flip sides of records. So stay tuned. You're going to love that one too.